At his first stop on a three-day round trip, salvage hunter Drew Pritchard has found himself face-to-face with a potentially explosive deal.
It's either working or it's going to blow up, one or the other. Yeah, that's working fine.
Turn it off.
Yes. We'd be selling this on, so we've got to rewire it.
People love to put those in their kitchens, and whenever I get one, it's sold like that, it's gone.
I think I'd be fair with you. What if we said, really fair, £200?
That is being really fair.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Is that all right?
That is a fantastic deal. Thank you very much.
Probably going to leave it as it is. I like it as it is. We're going to check the electrics out, though, because they're a bit...
In this workshop we've got here, there's an old Land Rover.
He's welding, yeah?
They always tend to need a little bit of welding.
Every Land Rover I get needs welding.
So it's just bits and pieces, really, in here, unless you want to buy a boat.
Definitely not. Don't like boats, don't like the sea, don't like going in the sea at all. I think the sea's just full of things that are going to eat you. I like this, Nick.
Oh, yeah, the waiting room sign, yeah.
Depending on their size, antique signs can often fetch hundreds of pounds each.
I like the fact that all the letters are sort of not quite straight.
Yeah,
they're all
jumbled up,
badly put on.
Ad hoc, aren't they?
Yeah, quite like that. Is that for sale?
Yeah. Again, like I said, anything's for sale, really.
What sort of price would you want for this?
I quite like the idea of you bidding me. And
it's a good decorative piece for a bar, restaurant, clothes shop. How does 75 quid?
Yeah, that is definitely.
Is that all right?
Yes.
Happy with that?
Yeah.
Brilliant. Yeah. Thank you very much. I like that. It's cool, isn't it? I like this as well. It's a really early 19th century English strapwork gate.
Even simple iron gates are highly sought after in home restorations and can easily swing up to £150 each.
Nothing fancy at all, nothing grand, knocked up by the local blacksmith.
Plain looks good, though, doesn't it?
Really, really plain. It's charming. It's just, it's got a certain charm to it. Thing, and it's still got the little latch thing on there as well. A really charming little item, and I can sell that fairly easily, so
yeah,
I'm really
pleased
with that.
Well, again, it'd be nice to see somebody use it again.
Oh, I don't know. Go on, then. I gave you a bid on the last one. You tell me what you want for this one.
50 quid.
50 quid. Stick it on the van. Yep, we'll have
that. Thank you.
Thank you. Another one bought. Thank you. Cool. Lovely.
Drew's visit to property developer Nick has unearthed some good pieces for his business, but Nick also buys and sells old cars.
I've been trying to ignore it since I walked in here, the 2CV.
Oh, dear. Drew's like a lamb to the slaughter.
Aha.
One of my loves.
This could be yours.
Oh, is it for sale?
It's for sale.
God, it's not, is it?
It is.
Another car in the offing and another chance for Drew to beat down his obsession. If completely restored, this iconic car could drive home a price of £3,000.
What state's the chassis in?
That's good. You know,
has it been patched over?
I think it's had an odd repair. I purchased a Citroën probably about 9-10 months ago. At one stage, I was going to give it to my son.
So I'm going to look at the chassis. It's a great big sheet right across the middle of the chassis, just a great big plate over the whole thing. The chassis rot like hell.
Wouldn't take much to MOT it, especially with the workshop here.
There's not many of them around. Some people hate them. I really like them. This is exactly the same as the first 2CV I had. I've had quite a few of these.
It's a 1986.
Two-cylinder. No, I do like them. I like the sort of peasantness about them.
Drew's car buying demons are definitely back and have found a friend in Nick.
I've got to stop just buying cars.
Stop next week.
Stop next week. Buy this.
Buy this one.
41,000, I say. The mileage is original, looking at the condition of the interior. So what would you want for it as it stands, then?
I think probably as it stood, 750.
750, ooh.
With an MOT, £1,000. That's how confident I am. That wouldn't take that to put it through.
I'm tempted. It's just a bit too much money.
I'm sure there's nothing on it which will be detrimental. I think a gallon of fuel and a battery, and she'll be away.
I do like the idea of driving it away with an MOT.
Yeah.
But I'd want to do that for 750 quid.
Yeah, well, that's a little bit too cheap for me at the moment. I think. Yeah.
A bit too much.
I think we could do sort of 900. I'd split you in the middle.
What if I come up to 8? Are we getting there? Because if you're very confident it's going to sail through MOT,
so the MOT itself will cost me £54.
Is that what it costs now for a test?
£850, and then you paid for the MOT at £8.
MOT'd. Drive it away.
Drive it away.
Another car bought. Just what I need.
Excellent.
Sorry, I can't help it. It's an addiction.
So you're addicted to something.
Yeah, I'm addicted to rust.
I can't believe it.
I think that's what it is.
Current score, Carbine Demons 2, Drew still 0.
Some of the things today, perhaps I've broken even on. Odd one, I've made a slight loss, but a couple of the others, I've made a slight profit. So overall on the day, I'm very, very happy. Careful of the cage.
Yeah, that's okay. Lovely, thank you, Nick.
And as they leave, Nick tips them off with the name of another collector in the area, who they plan to visit the very next day.
Thanks very much. Have a safe trip, and I hope tomorrow goes well.
Will do. Cheers. Thanks, Nick.
See you again. Bye-bye. Thanks, Jules.
Take care.
So, that was a good day. Enjoyed that.
Yeah.
Bought a little bit, paid too much for the clock. And the little sign, general waiting area. I could put that in the workshop. General waiting around and Gavin and Julian having a fag area.
Yeah, whatever.
Yeah. The turnstile, was it heavy?
Strangely, yes.
I wouldn't know. As soon as I saw you going to load that, I thought, I've got some important business in the kitchen with a kettle.